a nice cat. I do nice things for my family and friends. I do nice things for strangers. And yes, I usually do nice things for panhandlers. Why do I believe in random acts of kindness? Here's what happened. I'm 20-something years old, I'm living in Venice, California, and it's winter time. Now I know, a lot of people say winter in Los Angeles? What was it, 60 degrees? Granted, winters in Los Angeles, it's not Chicago winters. It's not Syracuse, New York, Rochester, Buffalo, Minneapolis. It's not Arctic freeze winter. But it gets cold, especially out by the beach. In California, even though 40 degrees, 30 degrees, it's not crazy. Hypothermia sets in when the body drops below 95 degrees. Somewhere between 1,000 and 2,000 people die from hypothermia in the United States every year. It's like saying you could drown in the ocean, you could drown in your bathtub as well. It doesn't matter how deep the water is, if you drown. So if you freeze to death, it doesn't matter if it was under 25 feet of snow in Buffalo, New York, or if it was on the beach in Santa Monica when it was 30 degrees. Dead is dead. I was living in Venice on my way home late at night, and there was a McDonald's on Lincoln Boulevard. I pulled into the McDonald's, and when I got out, there was this old gentleman who looked like Grady from Sanford and Son. If you've never seen Sanford and Son, check the link below and you'll see a picture of what Grady looked like from Sanford and Son. I'm telling you, this guy looked just like him. I got out of the car and he said, "Excuse me, sir, do you have 50 cents I could borrow to get a cup of coffee?" You had to see how humble this man was. He could be my grandfather. I'm 20 years old and he addressed me as sir, and could I please have 50 cents for a cup of coffee? And I said, "All you want is coffee." "Yes, sir." I said, "Okay, hang out. I'll be right back." I go inside to the McDonald's. I order a Big Mac, quarter pounder with cheese, two large fry, an apple pie, a cherry pie, and I get the large cup of coffee. I come back outside and I've got the bag and they put the coffee in the tray for me, and I hand the man the cup of coffee. And he's like, "Thank you so much." And I hand him the bag. And he looked at me. "This is for me?" I said, "Yeah." "Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you." He didn't say much. He just kind of bounced. And it wasn't like it was rude or anything. The man went right back over to the lamp, street lamp, where he was standing. He sat down, and it's going to sound funny, and I don't mean it to sound funny, but you know when you see a squirrel eat a nut? This man was hungry. He wanted to eat. And I remember the gratitude that this man expressed to me was so genuine and so sincere. And what really struck me is that he had food. He had food, and even if he just had the coffee, he could have turned around and gone right back inside to eat, but he didn't. He chose to stay outside. And I thought, why does this man feel, and many people have said it before, who were homeless, that they didn't want to impose or make other people feel uncomfortable by their presence in what is traditionally, you know, just a restaurant or someplace where everybody else normally just would eat and not think about it. They don't want people to stare at them or keep looking at their meal like they gotta grab their kids. They felt uncomfortable because they thought regular people felt uncomfortable. I'll never forget that. I'll never forget that. It didn't take much, it didn't cost much, but it meant a lot to him. He didn't even ask for it. He didn't ask for what he really wanted. He just asked for just enough to get by, just like coffee that would help keep him warm in that moment. And by going that extra mile in that moment, it made a huge difference for him. I felt good about it. Whenever you feel good, doctors and scientists will tell you, your brain will say, keep doing that. So I kept doing that. From that point on, I never wanted to exert the energy to try to figure out if somebody was trying to scam me or not. And more times than not, you can tell when someone is truly having a difficult time and somebody that's just trying to hustle me. I was on an audition, and it was like 10 years after, and this girl came up to me and she was saying, "You don't remember me, do you?" I was like, "No, what are you getting ready to say? And then I'm thinking, okay, let me go through my Rolodex. How could I possibly know her? She turned around to everyone who was auditioning and she said, this man at like 2 o'clock in the morning on a cold night, he stopped and performed a random act of kindness and pumped my gas for me. He didn't hit on me. He didn't ask for anything. He didn't say anything when he was done. He just let me stand in my car. I didn't have on a coat or anything and he pumped my gas. I thought, wow, how cool is karma that it came back to me, but it was years later. Whatever happened to full service gas stations? It's like Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. Recently, I saw something that said Gandhi might actually have not said that. And I was like, are you serious? It hasn't mattered since then, big or small. Paying the check for someone behind you in line. You know, you help somebody push the car in the street. You buy flowers for somebody who's, you know, having a bad day. It doesn't matter. Someone that does something nice for you and you do something back nice for them, you just do it. If you watch the news, people always say the nightly news could easily be called the nightly bad news. Why don't you hear more good stories? Instead of looking for them on the news, I try to live them. So in short, that's why I practice random acts of kindness. You should too. That's it for this week and the uplifting inspirational vibe as opposed to the death and destruction that's kind of been in the past 2 weeks. Thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Please subscribe, share this with your friends. If you want to learn more, you can check and click on the link below. Leave me a comment. Leave me a like. What I've found is people usually leave me comments, but it's like friends and they'll email me or something. Leave a comment here and I'm responding like to a friend who said, you look too stark with the white background and the black shirt. I'm like, but today, see, I put on a nice red shirt, so it's not the same as it is every week. I respond to my YouTube viewer input. That's a conversation. So I try to create compelling videos and listen. Matter of fact, if you have an idea of something you'd like me to do, add that, because after I get through about 50 videos, I probably need something new. Or just to do one because my YouTube audience asked for it. Thanks for watching this week. Again, did I say subscribe and share with all your friends? Sure, I think I did. And until next Thursday, that's what happened.